heart, because the Lord is with us. We are serving Jehovah Emmanuel, the Lord with us. What else do you
eat?
Amen.
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 Genesis chapter 12. Genesis chapter 12. Now the Lord has said to Abraham, get out of your country and from your kindred and from your father's house to a land that I will show you. I will make you a great nation, and I will bless you and make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. And I'll bless them that bless you, and curse him that curses you. And in you shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Amen.
Amen.
I'm talking about a calling. When God calls you, each calling has a promise. Immediately after Abraham was called, he was promised something. And that promise was a blessing. I'll bless you. I'll make you a great nation. I'll make you a great person. I'll make you that person that you think you will never be in the future. I don't know which area the Lord has called you from. I don't know which promise that the Lord has given you. But let me tell you, a calling is attached to a promise. And that promise is in form of a blessing. Sometimes a calling cannot be that easy, because your wife, your husband, your family, your friends, your neighbors, your age mates cannot understand you. They can't understand what you are pursuing. In fact, they will be the first people to oppose you. It was not that easy for Abraham, he was called Abraham by them, to come out of his land, to come out of his friends, to come out of the things that he used to do. Yes, it was not easy for you to come out of your family church, to come out of what you used to believe before, to come out of people's opinion. It is not an easy task. There is no calling that is easy. Every calling has challenges. Imagine Abraham is coming out, going to a place that you don't know. Callings, I'm telling you, God-given callings are directed nowhere according to human understanding. Once God calls you, yes, you may never know where you are going. You may never know where you are headed to. You may never know whom you are going to encounter. You may never know when will be the right time for you to receive your promise. But your role is just going and coming out. I'm coming out of that family's church. I'm coming out of that family's tradition. I'm coming out of that church that I used to go to. I'm coming out of my wife's advice concerning the church. I'm coming out of my husband's advice concerning the church. I'm coming out of all these things and going my way towards my calling. I'm just pursuing my calling. The reason why I'm coming out is because I was called, and the reason why I'm going is because I'm pursuing my calling. The Bible says, as Abraham was going, you know that there's no way in the Bible that the Bible shows Abraham fasting for 40 days. Do you know that? Yes. Let me tell you one thing. A calling is not followed by 40-day fasting. A calling is not followed by prayers. A calling is followed by faith in the promises that are attached in it. Do you know that? Prayer and fasting are for the powers equation. Abraham used to pray, he used to worship God, and his ways, but he never fasted and prayed and fought for his calling to materialize. Do you know that? Amen.
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 Sometimes we pursue our calling in the wrong direction. That's what made many people backslide and withdraw. Why? Because the Lord may be called you to perform a certain duty in the church, in the ministry, or in your life. But instead of standing in the promises, yes, you are pursuing it radically in a way that the Lord has not directed you to. There is a man whom the Lord showed in a dream that one day he will deliver people from demonic attacks and demonic chaos. So that man, immediately the next day, he started fasting for 40 days. It is said that that man succumbed into some ailments that are affecting him to date, even after 30 years when he was fasting. Why? He was pursuing his calling in a wrong way. Am I making sense?
Yes.
Let me go deeper. Abraham used to pursue his calling as per the promises of God Almighty. It is not by what we do, it is by grace. Bonus, if you will.
Amen.
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 And that's why fasting for 40 days, because you had to be Joshua fasted for 40 days, so that he operate in the way that you're operating in, is deception. Is it true? A calling can never be pursued by 40-day fasting. The Bible says, kazi ya Mungu alimalizia tangia mwanzo. The same Bible says, for the vision is for an appointed time. Though it tarries, it shall not tarry, it shall come to pass. Don't think that when you see a man of God prophesying and rebuking demons and doing all the hullabaloos that we see in TVs or anywhere we go to, it is because of their 40-day fasting. No, it never works that way. I was somewhere in the prayer mountains, and where I was, the Lord told me that 75% of people who are fasting there are not called to be ministers of the word. And most of them are prophets. Some are apostles. Some are pastors, apostles. Munuda munda sa mini pastor na mini apostle. Wow. What has been? Mungine amefunga mpaka ako. Anatembea kama ameinama. Wrong perception. It is not by what you do. If the Lord called you, what you have to do is to stand with the promises of your calling. Amen.
Amen.
But when it comes to fasting and prayer, those are for spiritual equation, for spiritual empowerment and spiritual protection. Satan, have you discovered myself a job that is no more righteous than him? Does Job fear you for nothing? Is it because you have put a hedge in his life that he fears you? So Job was in a ministry and he was blessed, not because he was fasting and praying, but it was his calling to be a successful man in life as per the will of God. But the worship part of his calling was for protection and a hedge in his ministry. Abraham never gave a sacrifice for him to be called. He was just somewhere standing and he heard a voice. Abraham, come out and I'll make your name great. I will bless you. So immediately when he heard that voice, he didn't fast and pray. He didn't went anywhere in the holy mountains to fast and pray. He just walked out of his father's house and went. What do sometimes believers gets it wrong? Okay, and I hear mtu ana prophesy in the TV, kitu ya kwanza unaangalianga ni fasting. What has he feeling?
Amen.
You are telling fasting to be magic. Is that true? Yes, yeah, okay. You know that there are prophets who started prophesying even without fasting. Maybe it is a promise that the Lord gave his grandfather that one day I will lift one of your sons to be my priest. So you just find yourself dreaming that you are preaching somewhere and you wake up one day in the morning and start preaching. Yes, it is a point as you start preaching, miracles happen. And as you start preaching and miracles happen, the Lord starts changing you. That's why the Bible says that we are his workmanship. He uses you as he's changing you. And how does he change you? In fasting and prayer. So fasting and prayer comes inside your walk to your promised land as per the promises of your calling. When the Lord called you. Eh? Am I making sense?
Yes.
Moses was not fasting in the holy Mount Zion. He was just somewhere and he saw a fire burning. And the Lord told him, Moses, I've called you, come and go to Pharaoh. Was he fasting? Was he raising altars? In fact, he was just somewhere, just sitting at the mercy. Maybe he was thinking where he would get buried, where he would be buried when he dies. Maybe he was thinking about his crooked wife or crooked children. Maybe he was thinking about things that he knows himself. But that's when God came. When the appointed time comes, I'm telling you, sometimes it may not come in the mountains until, unless the Lord directs you in the mountain. Sometimes it may not come overnight when you pray overnight for the Lord to respond unto your prayers. No, or unto your problem, unto your calling. Never. It never works that way. A calling comes mysteriously. We have testimonies of devil worshippers. Someone was worshipping the devil today, but tomorrow is turning to be a prophet. But tomorrow is exhausting demons, rebuking demons, they leave. No. The Bible says, the disciples of Jesus Christ, when they were with Christ, sometimes they used to rebuke demons. This is in our Shinda, or our Yesu, even to Shinda. This one of the beginning, I am talking about Kufunga and Kufunga, isn't it? So they used to work, they used to preach, they used to do wonders. Yes, without fasting and prayer. Till the disciples of John the Baptist asked Christ, why are your disciples not fasting? Christ told them, no, it is not their time to fast. When their master is here already, they'll fast when I leave. And that's what happened. When Christ left, they started fasting. So sometimes God can use you to prophesy, to deliver people, and to operate very high in spiritual endeavors without that deeper fasting and prayers. Then, after some time, when you are ministering, now the Lord will command you, now go to the mountains. Go to the mountains. Don't kill yourself in fasting and prayers if you don't have that grace to do it as at this time. Wait until the Lord speaks. Wait until maybe your spiritual mentor directs you. Why? Because these things happen or comes at an appointed time. And when that time comes, you will have that burden in your calling to accomplish what the Lord called you to accomplish. Abraham, come out. I will bless you. A promise sometimes comes or may come without fasting and prayers. Do you know that? Yeah, why? Because the work of God, Alimaliza Tangia Moses, is our Alpha and Omega. He knows your beginning from the end. Your end. He knows your ending from your beginning and your beginning from your ending. Why? That's why he's called Alpha and Omega. Am I making sense?
Amen.
Am I making sense?
Yes.
Am I making sense?
Yes.
Am I making sense?
Yes.
God has a few ways.
Amen.
So your prayer life, your fasting life, is for the power equation and protection. Why? Because the Lord called you long time ago. Everyone here has a testimony on how he connected or she connected to a living God. And I'm telling you, the first day you are connected to the real altar, some of us even never fast, we're not fasting. They were just roaming around in troubles and confusions of life, isn't it?
That's where the Lord called them.
Isn't it? Yeah, the Lord told them, that from today, I'll connect you to this anointing. And once he connected you, yeah, you felt truly I was connected. This is a divine connection. But let me use a legal term. However, we have believers who are worshiping God or who are pursuing their calling without wisdom. A cousin of mine was in a certain church. This is a real story. He saw the mentor, the spiritual authority in that church, and admired his life, her life. She was amazing. And this is what she full-time minister after the Gemia Grace. What was my Maisha to serve, isn't it? Which thing you want to amen.
Amen.
So that man admired that pastor. Why? Because of lust. And kwa natama, kwa nataka pia kwe full-time minister, na kwe prophet. Like she's a grace, yeah, what less. Which is good. The Bible said that desire good gifts. That's nothing wrong when you desire to be like me. Because Paul says, imitate me as I imitate Christ. So there is nothing wrong with that. But there are some people who are admiring it in lust. So that person, that cousin of mine, started fasting. 40 days fasting. After 40 days. 40 days fasting. I can't go baby yet. I can say my yako for full time ministry. I can't go to bed and be here. Oh, he started preaching. I don't have to have full time here. Which is not bad. But currently, as I'm speaking, he's not in full time ministry. He's working somewhere. Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Why? He's not operating in that anointing that he thought that he will operate in. Why? Because that is zeal without knowledge. My people perish for lack of knowledge. What does he do with that?
Amen.
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 Let me tell you one thing. Let me tell you one thing. You can't serve God without God. And furthermore, let no one deceive you that your promises will be achieved the same way he achieved his. The Bible says that his ways are not like our ways, and the Lord that we serve works in numerous and many ways. Your challenge to your blessing may differ from that other person's challenge towards his blessings and promises of God. Hey, my people perish for lack of knowledge. If fasting for 40 days could make people TB Joshuas, then in Kenya we could have 31 million TB Joshuas. If fasting can turn every Christian to be a TB Joshua, then we will have 31 million prophets in Kenya. Is that true? Is that true?
Yes.
Is that true?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, each and every person has his own different grace. Kuna mtu alibarikiwa tu akuwe mwerevu in class. Isn't it? Yeye kila mtu kile kitabu hivi, afungua ya pili akienda anapata A. But kuna mwingine akupatiwa hiyo neema. Atakaa na my encyclopedia the whole day. Isn't it? Akienda kwa exam anapata E. Isn't it? Mpaka anashinda, huyu mtu asomaki, anaweza kucomplain. Au walimu wananiambia, no! Grace, yule mtu ni ya kwenda kupass exam. Huyu yako si hiyo, yeye yako ni nyingine. Bwana asifiwe. You have to understand your call. You have to understand your purpose in life. You know, someone like Tony, maybe for my example. Do you know that sometimes in most cases, I don't prepare my sermons. Do you know that? I just stand here,
na imba haku na nishika leo nda ubiri nini ye Mungu someone inakunja
now tell your neighbor worry less tell your neighbor worry less
then a someone comes so it's not preaching like that na isn't it so I say wow
praise God
amen
but kuna mungine ana hiyo neema isn't it ndiye kuja preach hata chupa encyclopedia 6 dictionary 14
wakipuja hapa kila mtu analala
No, it is not your grace.
What has fear, sir?
You should know your role and shut your mouth.
What has fear, sir?
That's what makes people fight each other. Because you may start complaining. I pass too much
than that other person.
Why is it that this person is in favor than me?
That's what happened to Cain and Abel.
Me and me come to a quarter to this altar. Mimi ndio nimekuwa mtu wa kwanza kuinua madhabahu na kufungua kanisa. Inakuja kadogo kametoka nyuma yangu. Madhabahu yake inakubadilika na yangu ikubadilika. Au ndio mtu wale tu ambao wanapigana vita kwa makanisa, eh? I will kill this man. And he killed him. But the fact that he killed him is not the fact that he grabbed that promise and anointing that was in Abel.
There was saying that I had departed the faith in the eyes of God.
And Adam said, I know that the Lord has given me another seed for the sake of Abel. And he conceived a child called Seth, aka grow, aka Peter Cain, like you were pale
kwa God. Why?
Because it was not Cain's duty.
Natu wa watu kwa upeo.
Kuna pasa alikuwa nasema, neza kuchalaza kwa injili, nikutoa nje tena nikurudishe ndani. Amen.
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 Yes, each and every person has his own grace. Kuna mwingine atakuja hapa, atasimama tu watu wampende tu abnormally. Yeah, people just love this person. Yeah. Leo usimame hapa, uje nikukutafuta hiyo favor of course. At the end of the day, Hawa watu wanakuja tu kwa sababu ya that person. Hakuna kitu hapo. Hawa watu. No, maybe grace yako si ya kupendwa. Amen? So operate kwa hiyo grace ya kuchukiwa tu. Na useme nika wapo tu kama Esau. In your sword you shall eat. Yes, it doesn't matter how I eat, but I will eat anyway. Even. And that is my grace. Kuna grace ya kumove the mountain, the masses. Na grace ingine labda si ya kumove the mountain, the masses. Just operate in your grace. As you are wait for your appointed time, for the vision is for an appointed time. A coat of many colors was not made for the 12 children of Israel. It was just for Joseph. And that coat of many colors led Joseph into trouble. Why? Because his brother didn't understand that coat of many colors was not designed for them. Unajua I was monitoring the history of the children of Israel in the book of Genesis chapter 49. No, wana wa Israeli wanabarikiwa. Ube, ube, la, ni was table as water you shall be. Sigon and never you kill your brother, you kill someone. May my peace not rest upon you. I'll scatter you in the land of Israel. Judah, a scepter shall not depart from you. Take a shot. Judah depart your family. Now Joseph might give up, but your family because he is the best. Look at the characters that Judas. That Judah. Is it Judah? Yes, I want Yeshua to take care. Yeshua will take care of Joseph and take care of Judah, isn't it? The story goes that immediately Peter and Yehuza and Nguyao to the Ishmaelites, Agamatapesa, the book of Genesis chapter 38, ino nge the story of Judah, the whole chapter. Ina sema nienda akawana hiyo pesa immediately. Kwa hivyo ndoa yake ni wakwa raha, alioa, alinipa mahali na pesa kwa raha. Is that true? Hiyo ndio pesa alinipia mahali. Alimaradu pesa, pat, nakenda akawana. Amen. Lakini out of Judah, hapo ni Yesu alitokea. Judah kuna uzuri alikuwa amefanya. Yeah? Was he holier than them? No.
kazi ya Mungu aliipangia tangia mwanzo.
And he told Rebecca, Rebecca, an angel of God appeared unto Rebecca. Rebecca, I'm seeing two nations in your womb. One is cursed and the other one is blessed. The elder shall serve the other. Isn't it? Mm-hmm. When I talk in the womb, Esau the firstborn, Jacob the lastborn. If you could have judged the two by works, I'm telling you, Jacob and Alcoa cursed. That is by works. Isn't it? Because Jacob alikuwa lazy boy, a mama's boy. Kila sana mama yake kwa shukoni. Kila sana unajua mcheza kwa utunzwa. So I believe that he was very clean. Yeye kazi yake ilikuwa mtoto wa mama. Hakuwa different. But what about Esau? Esau alikuwa different. Alikuwa anaenda na mabibi wawili, Penina and Judy. Yeah? Anatembea na ua wanyama, anabeta, analisha familia yao at a tender age. Baki kila mtu akasema, wow, this man is blessed. But no, kazi ya Mungu alimaliza tangia mwanzo. Amen.
Amen.
And that's what I saw in the prayer mountains. Niliona mama Esau. When the first, mtu anaomba usiku, anakimbia 100 meters mpaka huko anarudi anakinabe first. Niko na hapa hakuna kufasi, ni chapati ziko kwa chumi. Because mtu amefast 40 days, anakimbia 100 meters. Amen. Mwingine alikuwa na somersault. I'm telling you, hata kama ni wewe, to be honest. Let us be sincere. Ukisema unataka kufast from morning to saa sita. Wacha 6 kubani. Because saide asibu unasikia gaji. Alafu wane mtu anabeba mtungi za 10 liters. Anaparadosa stairs na mna fast na yeye. You know you'll be like, eh? You know, wakia na huwa angu. Wakia na kaini superior than mine, eh? Huyo mtu amekuja fasti kuna chapati kwa bagu. Bwana asifiwe sana. Alafu anasema ni Mungu anampatia nguvu ya kurukaruka hivyo. 100 meters go, 100 meters to and fro. It is not by that 100 meters that you are saved. It's by grace. It is not by what you read, by the abundance of books you read, or by eloquency of language, or by your eloquency in linguistics. It doesn't matter how much eloquent you are in English or Swahili. It doesn't matter. It is by grace. What the grace of God is upon you. Even if you start a project, a full stop project, it will turn out to be a lie. You know, full stop is the beginning of any writing. Cynthia, that full stop. Because I'm about linguistics, but any language, any written language, start with a dot. Isn't it? Amen.
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 It is not by what you do, it is by grace. Bible is the end of it. Let me tell you, don't cheat yourself. Because you have to remind you for 40 days. Allah for Kuja was a prophet. There is not any prophet. Why? Because I fasted for 40 days. No! You don't prophesy because you fasted for 40 days. It can never happen. It is by grace. We pray in tongues by grace. We do all things that we do by grace. We move the masses by grace. People love us by grace. And if that grace is not upon you, then the more you push, the more you are rejected. The more you push, the more you fail. And the most likely you become to backslide and to be ejected from your ministry. Eh? Is that true?
Yeah.
Is that true?
Yeah.
So callings are pursued by the promises. Oh dear Lord, you called me, I go. I mean it's going wrong. But I remember the Lord called me and he promised me that I will preach to America. And I've never stepped my foot to America. So this sickness is not there to kill me. It is just something that is passing away. This is a valley of shadow of death. So I'll be here one day. So we know without hospital, but as a officer, you move on. Isn't it? Amen.
Amen.
Move away from promise, guys. Alafu kagojeka, ama kazi ikaenda. Yeah? If please kama uligojeka, you wouldn't have to work. Because of the matter hiyo, guy. The bona asifiwe.
Amen.
Mungu aliweka promise gani, kazi, again. Na kazi imeenda. That means your kazi ijaenda kukumaliza. Because, haujapata gari. Isn't it?
It is just another way. Maybe Mungu anakutoa from that department. Akupeleke department ingine. So that you get that car. I'm telling you, when God promises you something, even if you try to go away, even if you try to go astray from that promise, it must come to pass. And that's what the Bible says in the book of Isaiah, chapter 55. My words shall never come back unto me empty. Do you know that? Do you know that? Yeah, that's why when the Lord called Jonah, go up into the dead city of Nineveh. Jonah misbehaved, isn't he? And he reached a point of committing suicide. He told the sailors in the ship, throw me, I die. But the Lord said, no, you are not going to die because my words can never go back to me empty-handed. He found himself preaching. Then after preaching, again, I was there. I'm going to have a disaster. Then my dad, I'm sorry, you can keep yourself. Is that true? Amen.
Amen.
If the Lord is not done with you, you can't die.
Amen.
If the Lord is not done with you, you can't die.
Amen.
If the Lord is not done with you, you can't die.
Amen.
You must accomplish what the Lord has called you to.
Amen.
Even if you go astray, we will find a way of recollecting you and connecting you to the right path until you finish your purpose. After finishing your purpose, that's when you say, I fought a good fight, I've finished the race. But if you have not finished the race, I'm telling you, I don't know if you assume it was in a quarter. Amen. Because it's not done with you yet. But come on, Manzana, hey, you can have a very good. And because now, sir, you don't have any purpose for in life. So, you know, it's a real thing. I end up. One last view. Because I'm going to promise you a little bit. I'm going to promise you a poor minister. I'm going to go to my girl. I'm going to go to my girl. Utasaidia mapasta, utanulia pasta gani. Na mtu kwa Mungu wa shaki mwapena nulia pasta gani. Hey, I wish it was the one. Bwana asifiwe sana. Mimi nilikuwa the one ministry ya giving. Unio watu wako na ministry ya giving kwa napenduanga. Amen?
Amen.
Automatically. Hata kwa sakini mapasta wansema watu wako, pesa wase kuintimidate. But kikunye mbariki ya 100,000 leo. Chukua 7 million. Chukua Mercedes, hata kupenda automatically. Sema, hey! Hata hiko. Na atachukua tenge kuombea sana. Why? Gift ya gift inaletaka favor. Isn't it? But it's a special gift. Si gift kwa kila mtu. Bwana asifiwe. Don't force yourself to give and that gift is not in you. Amen.
Amen.
But let me tell you, if you have that gift of giving, hata kama wewe ni secular decision, na wewe ni mtu wa kutoa kama sonko, people will love you and God will give you words. Hapa na mna gani? Amen.
Amen.
When you give me the tax, salary for now. Because you can't give if you don't have. Before I buy you a Mercedes, me na kwa na chopa, isn't it? Hey, a person who gives you, a person who gives you, or a person who your father is your boss. Is that true? Huh? Yeah? Amen.
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 And that's why we encourage giving. If you have that grace of giving, give without expecting anything from those people. Mungu alinyima hiyo gift akaniingiza kwa ina operate ndani. Kwa sababu labda anajua ningekuwa na kiburi sana. Isn't it? Kazi ya Mungu imalizia tangia mwanzo. Bwana asifiwe. Sikutaka hii mambo ya preaching na kusimama kwa pulpit kujiexpose. Ndio kisoma hapa watu wanakusoma sana mpaka unachoka. Isn't it? Kwani unaenda watu wanakuandika tu. Amezea wapi huyo jamaa? Anaishiaje? Isn't it? But giving a kula kumuliko wa ima sana. You have your privacy. And I like privacy myself. What does it mean? But Mungu akona no. You don't fit here. You fit here. Where do you fit? Are you pushing yourself to eat? If the Lord is not in it, it will never happen. But if the Lord is in it, I'm telling you, you will never struggle. Muda kwa wazia, tuka mani give you resources ziko. Muda kwa kudua keyboard, 50,000, I'll give all of it. Nato usi mwe mkone, yote cha toa. Nato usi apie mtu nimetoa, that is my secret. Iye imeisha, eh? Nini ingine, tuna toke a land, ah, nimetoa 5 million. Iyo nimetoa, nato usi apie mtu nimetoa, that is my secret. Why? Because that gift is in you. Isn't it?
But when that kid is not in you, then you are not working on God.
I doubt what I'm going to want it, man. Me, I'm going to say, you know.
I mean, I know. I'll give 1 thumbs up. I'll give 10 thumbs up. That's how you are. Isn't it? Praise God.
Amen.
I don't want to struggle to give. And you put a party, your face, and back on the talk. No, isn't it? Why? Because you are forcing yourself to something that is not in you. We are not giving because of competition. Eh? We are giving because it is a gift. I have that gift of giving. I'm not preaching because of competition. I'm not fasting, I'm not praying because I want to be somewhere higher than that sister, than that other person. No, I'm doing that because the Lord has called me into it. Yes, I'm doing it in pride.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. You have to go fasting. You pastor moja hapo. Sijui ni pastor, sijui ni apostle. Lame sema yeye ajui kama ni pastor ama yeye ni apostle. Yeah, yeye ajui yeye mwana tu. Yeye anachukua kanisa mahali. But ajui position yake kama ni pastor ama apostle. Now where you go, that this man is operating on a spirit of confusion. So that man moved very close to me. And that's because I share kitanda. Yeye analala chini, mimi nalala juu. Amen. So, this man was very active. Kila saa amevaa vest. Unajua kwa mchana unavaa vest. Pita na ndoo shwa, anapita na ndoo shwa, amerudi. Na anaongea na saa kuja siri. Sasa this man, I don't know what he's doing. So, pia mimi nikajia touch na yeye. Nataka kuona hiyo ndoo ipige mtu bila kukia hapa. Praise God. So, ikafika mahali akaniambia, twende tukapime chai. Just one. Amen. Let us go. I'm going to pick you a simple attack on your own. I'm meeting someone here. Just go and attend to that person. I'm coming. So you can attend to that person. And I'm going to pick you a simple attack on your own. That person walks in that canteen. They were not a chapati singing. What are you doing?
Amen.
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 You are not in it. Don't force it. If you're not in fasting, don't force it. You'll be like Ananias and Sapphira. You will not be maturely for nothing. What are you doing?
Amen.
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 Don't say that you're fasting for 40 days and don't have that grace. You'll kill yourself. What has it been, sir? So callings are not pursued by works, but by grace. God, give me the grace to do it. You call me, and I'm awaiting upon you. Give me the grace. Give me your grace. Give me your grace.
Amen.
Give me your grace.
Amen.
Am I making sense to someone?
Amen.
Am I opening someone's eyes?
Yes.
Am I opening someone's eyes?
Yes.
Let us be wise.
Amen.
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 Hey, as I was telling you, there is a burden and a calling. So, now every believer has a calling. Once you get saved, you have a calling. But burdens, these are what you do. Mungu anakupatia burden over something. Kama basi tika. Is it not a burden? It is a God-given burden. I risk it. Is it not a burden? It is a burden to someone, Silvio. But a God-given burden that you don't just sacrifice and say, that's not part of my salary. This has stayed in ministry. Is that true?
Yes.
That is a God-given burden. But a man-given burden. So you know what a man-given burden is? I want to be like Abel. I'm Cain.
but I want to be like Abel. The Lord has not responded to me. I will kill Abel so that the back mini page I want to be here, so that the Lord to give me that anointing that was operating in Abel.
It never made sense. I think you have to be a fellow believer so that I forget what put me where we've been. It happened, it never happened. Because that anointing and that grace is not upon you. Is it tight? Is it tough? The Lord will come to you with from morning. Never tell me to come to you.
Amen.
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 So, if you then try to take a burden to yourself, you'll become a burden to people. Because the minister you are operating in is man-made. But Mungu anakusikia sometimes. But you are a man-made minister. Eh? You are making yourself by praying. Yes, I'm thinking that you can prophesy. You push your bandits to yourself. You will become people's bandit. But I can say, because I am going to say, Muzimu ni batia pesa wa shirika mutanaaniwa. What is that? Yeno na pesa, haki na fedewe kwa shirika. Hey. I'm telling you, if you want to be a great minister, be a Moses. Feed the flock. Feed the flock. Spiritually and materially. Be in a position to give also. Is that true? As Jesus Christ, he fed the flock. Moses fed the flock with manna and quail. But don't be a bad minister. No matter what bad. To people, what's the only one about is a Kimbia? What a shame! Praise God! Praise God! Yes, imagine that I'm going to be a Kimbia. Does it make sense? Does it make sense? No, it means I'm a burden to you. Isn't it? How will I be in a position to sort you out? You have a wife, you have children, you have to take care of them. Also with your salary. Suddenly, you have to take a salary. That is stupidity. Mercy has a wife, he has his children, he has things to do with his money. Come on, can't be abandoned to Mercy. No. I'm not again. Amen. Even no one will respect you. That's why many pastors are despised. Because he who feeds you can abuse you, can abuse your mother in your presence. You only can do it. Amen. Not much of a wengi, woman to come is it goes out, woman we care our heart. Is it? Now to be open a music goes out. So, me don't take a day, kill a son in the Tayoka, in the table of Tayoka, I got a company of five more. Who put a year she wants to come on? One day I enter, I'm taking independence. Why? Because I'm a burden to you. In a book with a bomb, I connect you, I help you to be a somebody. Hata huu kichia kano sema wahu, kweli kutoka ni kutahenda ule jamaa, my life has changed. But siya ni kukutahata mimi, tina ni kwenyete ni ziko, ni chukue mpaka school fees yako, I understand very well that salari yako ni ndugu, but mimi ndo jifidigia hako, sasa nyumba yako ndiyo mimi, sasa ndiyo naenda kukula samba huko, ni kama kundiyo part of that family, utachoka, I'm telling you, you will get tired. Am I making sense?
Yes.
You have a calling. Don't be a burden to some. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to pastor somewhere. ameenda ameshika ploti ya mshirika na ana demand kuishi hapo bure, tena anataka mshirika amlishe. Ni mshirika ana depend in that plot. What is that? Yeah? Mpaka mzee wake nyumba anashindwa, anasema sasa mimi na hii plot nimeitengeneza nijisaidie na mke wangu. So this man anaishi hapa, namlisha watoto wake. So what is it? Naposa kila saa threats. I will curse someone. Bila mwambia, I will inject and tell you, go to hell and face the wrath of your demon. Let me tell you, okay, meet such pastors, inject them immediately. Mwambia, they have to go back to Jacaranda and seek God. Hizo shida za uchungaji zinapatika miaka in the wilderness. Amen? Okay, if you clear your wilderness journey perfectly, you'll never be a burden to someone. Never ever. Is that true?
Yes.
Is that true?
Yes.
Is that true?
Yes.
Yeah, that's why kuna wachungaji wengi wanatengeneza bahasha za fungu la kumi alafu wanaweka tu box. Isn't it? Tukuangalia, hiyo print yako ni red. Na mimi nilimwombea akapata hiyo kazi. Na kuambia wapendwa wangu kwa kuingiza kiburi. Nilimwombea akapata kazi. Na kupata kazi kumpatia bahasha ya fungu la kumi. Nikaona ma box zinaanza kukosa kujazwa. Nikaona ma box zinakosa. Ilibidi nirudi kwa Bwana. Nikalaani hiyo ndugu. Na sasa vile naongea, I'm going to burn you. What is that? That is stupidity. Yeah. Masa kama wewe mwambie, go to the dogs. Amen. Kuna watu wanakutana na wachungaji kama hao, isn't it? Hao ndio walitoka kwa wilderness, kama siku zao za kukaa kwa wilderness zijaisha. Amen.
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 Amen. And that's what Paul preached akisema, sibu wa mzigo kwenyu, I need to sustain myself. I didn't depend in your offerings, in your tithes. I need to sustain yourself, myself. But, kuna watu walikuwa wanakuja by force, wanasema hapana, this man, mpaka tumbariki, isn't it? Kama niyo, it is okay, eh? But it's not a must that I depend on you. Na mwene sile pesa zimeingia, ile Lord umechukua, I did, no! Na nikifanya kitu kama hiyo, kama ni mimi, rebuke me. Anza kuambia tuni sasa wewe naona kuna pepo inakuingia. Ukiona na kuja kwa labda sema, hey, hii TV ni mzuri, ukinibariki na hii TV mbona nakupatia ingine. No, hii ni mimi. Send me out of my house, kara mimi. Be hide from me sasa. Praise God.
Amen.
This is the racket that is going outside there. Isn't it? Hii wachungaji wana burden, washirika mpaka washirika wanachoka. Yeah? Let me tell you, if you don't have that grace of giving, don't. Sasa tunasema tunachanga, it's not sure. Tunachanga tu before tunataka viombo pia sisi. Adora Madonna. Kama una, don't lift your hand. God knows. Siku yako ikifika, you will lift your, you raise your hand. And you will give by grace. Amen. Ukisikia tu anatoa 50,000. Au ujui anayo 50,000 ametoa. Ujui kama ataomba ambie Mungu nikitembea kwa njia ni aokote hiyo pesa. Na hiyo uko taka pesa zile yuko hapa eh? Si ndio? Labda Mungu akaona hizo pesa tunaleta, isn't it? Na wewe labda una struggle ndio ipate, isn't it? So ukishaitoa unaanza kufunga rent, unaanza kuteseka nje, alafu unaanza kusema hii kanisa. Hii kanisa imekuwa laana kwa kitu. Don't do that. Amen. When God gives you the grace, do it. But if that grace is not there, don't. Ambia Mungu, you are the God, you are the Lord who gives the sower, the seed to sow. Today I don't have, but tomorrow I have. I know that you'll give me that grace to do it because I have that word and I feel like I'll give, well, I'll be a great giver one day. Wait until your time comes. Eh? Is it making sense?
Yes.
Am I making sense?
Yes.
Am I making sense?
Yes.
Am I making sense?
Yes.
I don't know why nimeongea sana. Siku nataka kuongea hivi sana. But the Lord is just pushing me. But once the Lord calls you, just maintain that calling. Just maintain that calling. And it's also good to fast and pray. Siambia mtu asifunge na kuomba. Fast and pray. Because it is recommended. The Bible says that pray without fasting. And the same Bible says that mengine hayatoki kwa kuomba na kufunga. Na kama ni spiritual battle, pigana kabisa ambao hakikisha umesambaratisha kila kitu. It is 100% correct. Amen? But don't dwell on that to the promise, to the promises of the Lord gave you. No. Obama boy fast for 40 days, but he's a president. Kwa hivyo kuna baraka zingine, material blessings zingine, they just work and come to pass automatically. Hey. Amen.
Amen.
Let us be disciplined believers. Who is disciplined? Na utaratibu grace inakufuata. People will just come.
around you. Now, you're going to what about your car? Because you're not a burden for them. If you're going to go to the house, you're going to go to the house. Because they're comfortable hanging around you. Then you can say, Nipe, Saidia, Nipe, Mini Pastor. Hey, Bari Abari, hello, Uko. Yes, you got to go and be the dog of the school children. You're going to go to the and you're a pastor. That means, And the Lord never blessed people like that. Blessings of God comes automatically. Let me tell you how I survive before I start praying. Me, I don't worry spending money. I just spend. I don't worry. I don't waste your food in my house. Yeah? Isn't it? Yeah?
Yes.
Is it true? Yes. But if the pesa we generate, the chakula we give on your bayang, why don't I don't know. That's the only company which you are mwezi, I'm on the bills, I don't know about it. And I don't borrow, I don't tell people, I know I don't do some things. Why? Because I'm serving the living God, who is above everything. And I'm sure with my ministry, I went to my wilderness and finished it completely. Now I'm living by the grace from my wilderness. So I can't be intimidated. That's why I'm not shaken by anything. But I'm declaring a present now. Because I don't need it. What has it been with that?
Amen.
Yes, I know again, when you become a president, but I save, we preserve. Which is good. But me, I don't even take their numbers. I meet very great people, but I don't even take them. Because I don't need them. I'm serving a living God. Be like that. When God calls, when you have a calling, and when you're pursuing your calling, you have to elevate your status. Yeah? Yes, status yako mpaka ibadilike, spiritually and materially. Am I making sense?
Yes.
It is shameful to see pastors fighting for sadakas, na fungu na kumis, the way we see in TVs. This means that these pastors, how come they are wilderness, zile walikuwa wapitie somewhere. That's why they are panicking. I want to mentor and nurture strong believers who have strong faith. And who live by the grace radically, out of faith that they have, standing in the promises that are attached to their callings. Amen. So if you have that calling, kama Mungu amekupatia grace ya that calling na kumtafuta kwa roho na kweli na that zing ya kuenda kufasa na kadhalika, that means you have a calling. Stand with it. Na usiangalie anything, anybody or anyway. I'm going to hear that calling and it shall come to pass automatically. Automatically. But as it is,
amen.
We don't force ourselves to these things, they just come.
Amen.
But when it comes to prayer and fasting, you have to force yourself. Upon a scapegoat, you have to pray. Yeah? But when it comes to materialization of your blessing, they will just come. Unaweza tafuta kazi for many years. But kupoja na kuna skeptoni umepata kazi automatically. Why? Because they don't promise you that you'll get a job. It's not because umesoma or you are connected, but because a promise of God is being fulfilled. What else if you say? So let us depend on these promises. Let us operate on these promises. Let us meditate on these promises. And it shall be well with us. Let us turn. But also will not save a captain and base him out of us. Mataifa yote yatakusanyika mbele. Yeah.
in full-time ministry. I want believers who will operate by the grace and will be sustained by the grace of God upon it. Amen.
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 Do you know that to my surprise, when I went to a yine, out I would be blessed like a tano, say, man, I don't need it. I don't need it. I'm going to be blessed by force. And I'm going to call your blessing. Come on, we're talking to people. That means your blessing is going to end. But I'm going to say, wow. Why? Because I'm operating by grace. And the grace of God upon me is commanding these blessings to locate me, whether I like it or not. That's how ministers who are ministering by grace and who are living by grace lives. They are not living by begging, nor disturbing people. They live by grace. What else do you say?
Amen.
The grace means blessings overtaking you. I don't want him to have swine to come to me, but they were swine to be an airtime ten. Just pause, we mean to be airtime and torture. So if you have a save, you do something with your money. Come on, I'm going to go for more sea for me to be a 1,500 airtime. What is wrong with this man? Praise God. Now, I'm a watch, I'm a 500. Yeah, they made 2,000 yote. No, but enough kiri amo. Sabi ona tuma na na bosa sa. Tuna me tupe tu an. Aish. That is grace of God. When grace of God is upon you, blessings will overtake you, and they will come to you by force. You will not force them, but they will come by force. You will not force to drive a car. It will come by force. You will not force to get a job. It will come and overtake you by force, even after a long struggle. And that's what I want to release upon you today. In your business, in your career, in your ministerial life, the grace of God is overtaking you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Maybe sometimes you used to force things to come your way. You used to force respect. You used to force finances, practice. But in vain. But today, I want to release a special anointing upon you. So the Lord Almighty to bring these things by grace. That these things will overtake you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Are you ready for it?
Yes.
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 Are you ready?
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 Yes.
Are you ready? Let me tell you. Not today, afternoon will come and expect that home bam back in the open in hours. No, to measure over from morning to now, Zaini will release to me. I feel that grace of mercy.
Amen. Amen.
Spiritual realm sometimes is very funny. You know, Solomon was a man of God. Alitumika na Mungu kwa uzito. But aliondoka kitu moja. He broke a neck from Famila's hopper to a demon Moloch. And that was his end. That's how blessings and miracles work. Sometimes you may pray the whole night, the whole week, but in vain. But saying that is about 1 minute and something happened. And that's what I want to do, Sai. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Are you ready to receive it?
Yes.
Are you ready to receive it?
Yes.
Ready to receive the grace? Oh dear Lord of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, you have been living by force. You have been living by sword. Oh, they have been living by death, by telling people to bless them, by commanding blessing their way, by commanding deliverance their way. Oh, but today is the end. No more foes. No more works. No more reward by works nor foes. But by your grace. 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 In Jesus' name. By it's by grace that your people are released. It's by your grace that they are getting jobs. It's by your grace that their businesses are being expanded. It's by your grace. I can feel the power. I can feel the power. I can feel it.
I can feel the power. 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 The power of grace. The power of grace. The power of grace. In your business. In your job. In your wife. In your husband. In your business. In your finances. I feel the grace. I feel the grace. I feel the grace. I feel the grace. Raise your hands up. I want to release the grace. Oh, the grace of God in your career. The grace of God in your business. The grace of God in your family. In your marital status. In your marital life. In your children. Receive it.
Receive
it. Receive it. To support your children in school, the grace of peace between a mother and a son and a man and his man. I release it.
Receive it.
Bakoso bolose de keli desu bokoti. I can feel the power of God. I can feel that power in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I can feel that power in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I can feel that power in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I can feel that grace in Jesus' name. Every love call you can be a cabisa. You know, you very straight. What do you feel about what I'm calling you? Could not want to feel something like a warmth?
Yes.
You feel it?
Yes.
You feel it?
Yes.
You feel it?
Yes.
Don't say yes if you're not feeling it. Do you feel that great? You want to scare to come like a motto?
Yes.
Just eat. What is here? Basin, do you feel it?
Yes.
Basin, do you feel it?
No.
Yeah? But Basin is not feeling it. But kuna mtu ana feel? Nani ana feel? Who is feeling it? Kuna mtu ana feel it, eh? Yes, but the Lord not pass you.
Amen.
Kama ufile mutembea, tafuta position. Yeah? Nani ana feel? Kuna mtu ana feel? Inua juu straight. Kama ufile inua juu, eh? Do you feel that grace? Do you feel that fire? Do you feel it?
Yes.
Bakoso bolose neke. Baloso bokote. Mimi wale wana feel you. Receive your grace. Financial grace. Health grace. Health grace. Your healing. Your finances. Your breakthrough. Receive it. 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 I feel that grace is a financial breakthrough. I'm gonna release the grace of financial breakthrough. Grace of financial breakthrough. Yes. Kuna mtu amechoka kwa mkono tu, eh? But you feel it, eh?
Yes.
Hey, leba kaso bolose de kete. I release it!
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 I release
it!
Anything?
Yeah? Do you feel some more? If you don't feel it, don't say that you feel it. Do you feel it?
I feel it like behind my head.
Oh, labor council will not see again. But no sobok. There is too much power here.
Yes.
There is too much power here. Yes. But also will not see again. Does someone feel it? Nobody's
yes.
Hear that.
Yes.
Let's hear.
Yes.
Oh, labor council will not see. Nani aski? Don't say yes, come on, just hear. Yes, I want everybody to be part of this. Kuna mtu aski? Okay, mostly we put your hand down. Yeah. Kuna mtu aski? Kuna mtu haiski? Kuna mtu aski? I just hear.
I surrender my life.
John. The meeting off. Yeah, because the Lord lives in the abundance of his praises. I surrender, oh,
I surrender my life.
It's like something that is happening just here.
I mean it. That last Sunday, kuna watu wanajua simame hapa. Ndio natoa touching testimony.
In our pastor's house, in our spiritual leader's house, in every